Very good afternoon to all of you present over here, and a warm welcome to you all in this interactive session. So this is Priyanka Das.
We cannot see you.
Okay. Just a minute.
Yes, that is sister.
Just a minute. One message is showing that you cannot start your video because the host has disabled it. Okay. Thank you.
Yes. Welcome, madam.
Thank you. A warm welcome to you all in my interactive session. A very good afternoon to all of you. This is Priyanka Das, and today, before start anything about this pandemic situation or about this interactive session, I need to focus on some points, like why we have gathered here, what are the need of this kind of session, and how this session, this interactive session, is relevant for all of us during this pandemic situation. Okay. So today I have made this interactive session into three parts. One part we will discuss COVID-19 and mental health. In the next part, we will have the problems and the intervention strategies, coping strategies. And the last part, we will have a small interactive session so that we have our doubts, so that we can clear it out. So we know that we are going to finish 6 months of this new year, but it seems that this year has not brought anything new and any good messages, good news for all of us yet. We all are stressed, disturbed, anxious, scared, worried due to this pandemic, COVID-19. So we all are struggling to stay well, to keep others well, and above all, to survive. In these circumstances, we need to focus on our mental health, because if our mental health is okay, then everything is okay. So this is the high time that we have to give importance to our mental health. Why? Because if our mental health is in a better position, then definitely there would be many possibilities and positive thoughts that can be welcomed. So keeping these in mind, I have selected one topic, and I am going to interact with you all with the topic COVID-19 and mental health, the challenges and interventions. So I'm sharing some screen. Okay, so COVID-19 and mental health, what are the challenges and interventions? So when we have this kind of topic, there are many questions that come to our minds. What are the mental health problems? How do we overcome from this? What are the challenges? How do we get rid of this problem? How do we deal with this problem? And all above, how COVID-19 is related with our mental health? We will have a look how COVID-19 is related with our mental health. We all know that COVID-19 is a pandemic situation, and it is a crisis for all of us. So we don't know how to cope up with the situation, how to adjust, how to modify ourselves with these situation, how to fit in the situation, because we have never faced such a situation before. So it is very normal to feel sad, anxious, disturbed, frustrated, angry, and worried during this crisis. Because fear and anxiety about new disease, and as we don't know how to overcome from this situation, so it makes strong emotion in adults as well as in children. Apart from this, there are new terms we have experienced in these months, like social distancing and quarantine. So there is a question, is social distancing making mental distancing? Isolation or quarantine mean social isolation and mental isolation, mental quarantine. So these words make people feel isolated and lonely, and it increases stress, anxiety, and depression within themselves. So if we think about in a better way, if we cope up with all the new strategies, if we aware of the situation, if you take the precautions, definitely we will be able to overcome from this situation, and it will be benefited not only for us but for people with our near and dear ones and the community. So it will make ourselves as well as all the participants, everybody stronger, because we all have to fight with the situation, and at any cost we have to overcome from this pandemic situation. Now the next slide is we know that in this COVID-19 or in this pandemic situation, not only we have problems, we have mental health problems, we have many problems as well. Then what are the problems? In COVID-19, we have the following problems, like mental health problems, physical health problems, domestic violence, financial insecurities, and above all, struggles for existence. So mental health problems mean we are getting nervous, anxious, scared, worried, disturbed. We don't know seriously how to overcome from this situation. So our mental health is getting affected by this situation. What is physical health problem? People who have been suffering from physical illness, or due to mental health problems, there are certain physical health problems like increase of heart rate, blood pressure, chest pain, headache, body pain. So mental health and physical health, we all know that these two are interrelated. So if we have mental health problems, we will have certain physical health problems too. Next, in COVID-19 situation, we have increased level of domestic violence cases. We have got many domestic violence cases. Why? Because people don't know what to do, how to do, how to face the situation, how to fight the situation. So they are getting nervous, they are scared, they are worried, as they are unable to manage the situation. So they feel very much frustrated, short-tempered, and aggressive. So domestic violence cases are there. Next is financial insecurities. What is financial insecurities? Financial insecurities due to lockdown. Many people lost their job due to lockdown. Many got down in business. And we always struggle for our existence. We, apart from this COVID-19 situation, simultaneously we have to think for the existence. We have to struggle for the existence. But we have insecurities. We have financial insecurities. So all these lead to mental health problems, and we seriously don't know how to solve out or how to overcome from this. So the next slide is then we are discussing that we have a mental health problems, but usually or generally who are the victims? Victim are those who have lost their jobs. It means that we all have mental health problems, but those people who are suffering a lot from these mental health problems are the victims I have mentioned in the slides, like people who have lost their jobs or any changes happened in life, or people who have any kind of disabilities or developmental delays, like children, autistic children, or mental retarded, or people who have any kind of mental health problem, people who are socially isolated from others, including who live alone. My parents are there in Mumbai. I live alone in Kolkata. Seriously, I don't have anyone whom I can share my problems, my feelings. I seriously don't have anyone in this pandemic situation whom I trust the most, whom I care the most. I seriously don't know how to deal. I feel very lonely, very disturbed. And people experiencing homelessness, those who are getting affected in the COVID-19, they also are the victims, and they also develop mental health problems within themselves. Who are the victims? There are many victims as well, like people who have severe illness. I have already mentioned people who have been suffering from mental health problems already or physical health problems. They are getting affected faster than others. Children and teens. Why? Because they are impatient. They seriously don't know. They have not faced situations like this before. They don't know the meaning of lockdown. They don't know how to survive because friends are not there. We are not doing any hangouts. We are not doing any parties. We are getting socially isolated. How to deal? They are getting impatient. People who care the most for the family members. For example, I live at Kolkata. My parents or my dearest one or nearest one, they live in Delhi or Mumbai, but the condition of Mumbai and Delhi are not very good. So usually those who have the attachment, those who have strong attachment with others, who care for others, they usually are the victims. They usually get emotionally affected and they have the mental health problems like anxiety, fear and depression within themselves faster than anybody else. Next, frontline workers. On healthcare providers like doctors, nurses and the social workers who are helping people out from these situations. And already mentioned who have existing mental health problems, and last but not the least, who have substance abuse disorder. That means who have unhealthy coping strategies like taking alcohol or drugs and so on. So they are the victims. We all are the victims actually, but these people are getting affected faster than anybody else. Okay, so what are the problems? We need to discuss what are the problems, what are the mental health problems. These are the mental health problems I would like to request everybody to have a look on the screen. First problem that we have, fear and worry about own health and health of your beloved ones. That means, would I be okay? Would I be infected in this disease? How do I overcome from the situation? No, I will not be able. I am a failure. Seriously, I am not managing everything. So people are getting feared. People are getting scared. And they are disturbed. So they are suffering from depression. Depression, as they are isolated from the beloved ones or from the family members. Depression, as they are, again, as the things are getting unmanageable, depression because they feel very scared, depression because they feel very anxious. They have sleeping difficulties mean like unable to sleep properly at night, or they're sleeping too much. Eating patterns, there is a change in eating patterns, like unable to eat properly or eating too much. In addition to this, there are some problems like unable to concentrate properly. They have inability to complete the task. They feel very low. They feel very depressed, very sad. They are getting short-tempered, frustrated, and sometimes this social isolation makes these people who are getting affected by these mental health symptoms withdrawn, moody, irritable. They even do not communicate in the family. They make themselves locked because thought is coming to their mind, I am not able to deal with the situation. What would be the future? How would I bring back the situation normal? So these are the thoughts that come to their mind. So apart from this, there are some mental health problems. I'm sharing the screen. Okay. So apart from this, which I have already discussed, there are some mental health problems too. Recurring negative thoughts, repetitive negative thoughts, I can't do it, I am a failure, I can't manage this situation, oh, my home situation is not appropriate, oh my God, how can I deal with the situation, no, I would not be able to deal positively. Yes, I am thinking positively, but there are negative situations all around. How can I deal? How can I survive? Many people are getting infected by this disease. If it happens with me, what would be the result? How can I deal with the family members? What my family members would think? If I experience the COVID-19 symptoms, the people will monitor me. I will monitor myself. Oh, I don't know how to do it. So these are the recurrent negative thoughts that come to the mind. Next is unhealthy coping strategies. People who usually do not have any alcohol or drug symptoms, like people who do not take alcohol or drugs, they are taking unhealthy coping strategies and they are taking alcohol and drugs to deal with the emotions they have or they feel. So if you feel overwhelmed, please take a professional help. Next is worry about getting infected or reinfected or sick again. There is no symptom within myself that a COVID-19 symptoms. So no chance is there to get infected in this disease. Still, I have negative symptoms. I have negative thoughts to get infected. Or if I have already got the experience, I have a fear or I have a worry to get reinfected or to seek again. So these are the things people are not able to overcome from. Next is the last one is guilt about not being able to perform normal work. We usually have a routine. In the morning, we go to the office or we do our professional work. We back home, we spend with the family members. We do some professional work left and we go to sleep. So this is the routine, but in these days from February onwards, this routine has been changed and we are unable to perform normal work. We don't know seriously when the situation would become normal. And next guilt is survival guilt. I am in Kolkata. My friends, my family members, my close ones are in Mumbai or in Delhi or in Chennai, and I am unable to help them. Or even I am in Kolkata. I am in Kolkata Toliganj. My friends and family members are in Behala. I am unable to help them out. They are suffering a lot of problems. They are facing a lot of problems. I am unable to do any kind of help. So I have survival guilt during this COVID-19. So these are the problems. These are the problems that usually we face. Now the next important part is, if we have this kind of problems, how do we overcome from the situation? Because we know the problems. We know the problems, but we don't know the intervention. We have the problems, but we seriously don't know the coping strategies. So the next slide is obviously coping strategies, how to deal with COVID-19. First, the first and important thing that we have to do, we must do, we have to minimize reading or watching news related to the pandemic. We know the situation, we know how to deal with, or we know that we cannot change the situation. This situation will be continued either for 2 months, 3 months, 4 months, or a maximum 1 year. So the more we have lot of news, lot of information, the more we will be able to get involved in those mental health problems. So the more we minimize reading or watching any news related to pandemic, we will be able to do better. We will enhance our quality of life. Next is, if we seriously want to seek any information regarding this pandemic, we can have it from reliable sources like WHO or the Government of India Health Ministry website, so that we can assure ourselves that yes, these are the situation happening all around. Next is, we have to keep some we have to establish a daily routine. How do we do it? Daily routine means we have to start a day with good vibes, positive vibes, and we have to separate, we have to make a routine, and through this we have to channelize ourselves. And how to do it? We have to separate all the professional and personal activities to ensure efficiency and to maintain a work and life balance. So if we make a routine and list down that this is the work time and this is the non-work time, this is the work time where I will complete all the professional activities, and in non-work time I will complete or I will engage myself in some personal activities, definitely you will be able to manage it. Next, as we know that mental health and physical health, these two are interrelated. So we have to involve ourselves in some exercises or yoga to boost our physical and mental health. This is the time. See, if we change our situation, change our thought and perception, this situation is not only a bad situation, it also gives some positivity. How? Because this is the time where you motivate yourself, where you feel optimistic and energized. So, if it is possible that you enhance your quality of life, you engage yourself in some activities that are pleasurable to you, that gives you satisfaction, or you used to do it in the past, but now with your busy schedule, it is unmanageable sometimes, you cannot do it. Please start those activities. Engage yourself in those activities, because trust me, it gives you pleasure, it gives you satisfaction. And when it gives you pleasure and satisfaction, definitely it gives you motivation. It gives your self-confidence back. Apart from this, you can make some daily activities. You can involve yourself in some daily activities like gardening, cleaning, or cooking to reduce anxiety. So you can make it on your own. Next, some more management or dealing with COVID-19. You can spend some time on recreational activities like games, like TV, like music, like reading, anything. Or the most important thing, as you are getting enough time to spend quality time with your family members, so please spend quality time with your family members and get involved in family discussion. Think about your childhood days. Discuss it with your family members, or take some indoor games. It will bond, it will bring back your family bonding that sometimes is unmanageable due to your busy schedule. So COVID-19 is giving you this opportunity to reassure and to remake your family bonding once again. Next, plenty of sleep and a nutritious meal. Eating nutritious meal is extremely important. Why? Because to fight with COVID-19, we have to boost our immunity system. So we have to take care not only about our mental health, but with physical health too. Next is very important. Fix some scheduled me time. What is the meaning of it? Scheduled me time. Yes, I know that you have some professional duties. Yes, I know you have some personal duties. Yes, I know that you have some duties that you have to do. You have some responsibilities that you have to do for your family members. But apart from this, you have a responsibility. You have responsibility for yourself too. So start self-pampering yourself. Fix some scheduled me time. This time is only yours. Please spend some time with yourself. Please ensure that you are making yourself strong. You are rediscovering yourself. Please. Why? Because this busy schedule, or by doing all the responsibilities, by performing all the responsibilities, it is not possible for you to sometimes take care of yourself. So this is high time when you can take care of yourself. And for that, you can obviously make a routine. Work on skills you have used in the past. We are talking about the hobbies or the likings that you had in the past, but right now you are not doing it. Please challenge yourself towards the work that you have in the past or you used to do. Definitely you are getting separated from your family members or from your close and nearest ones because of this social isolation and social distancing. But remember always, social distancing does not make you have a mental distancing too. You have only social distancing, but you can get connected with your family members or your loved ones. So phone calls, video calls, chats, social media to reduce your stress. So I know that we are not prepared. We did not prepare for this situation. So there are many expectations that you have already, or there are many plannings, many plannings, plenty of plannings you have. But right now you have to stop everything. So manage your expectation. Why? Because this situation will definitely pass. Nothing is permanent in the world, not even our worries. So this is the time where you have to please control your expectations and take all the days as it comes. Don't think about the future. Just think with a good vibes or positive vibes and start a day with positive thoughts and say to yourself that I will spend the day on my own. I will spend the day on my own. I will do all the activities, not only for myself, but also for the family members. That only gives me pleasure, because in these periods, satisfaction is very important. Getting pleasure is very important. Relaxation is very, very important. So, based on that, I have made my next slide, and it is stop worrying and start living. How do you do it? Don't think about the future, as I just told to you all. Just live each day as it comes. Don't plan anything for the future. With the hope, just leave all the day that this situation will definitely pass. Ask yourself, what is the worst that can possibly happen if I can't solve the problem? I'd like to request all the participants here to immediately think or ask yourself this question. I know that you all are suffering some mental health problems. Even I am also suffering from mental health problems, because seriously, this situation, we are not preparing for this situation. But please ask yourself, what is the worst that can possibly happen if you cannot solve the problem? So prepare yourself mentally to accept the worst if necessary. Yes, I may be getting affected by COVID-19. My family members may be COVID-19 in my family. I may be getting reaffected by, I may be sick again. I cannot help it. I cannot solve it. But what can I do? I can take some precautions. I can give some awareness to myself. I can implement some coping strategies. Definitely, I will manage the situation. So then calmly try to improve upon the worst, which you have already mentally agreed to accept. In this situation, you have to do some thoughts. You have to work on some thoughts. What? First, accept the situation. Because I have seen in many cases after this COVID-19, that in maximum cases or most of the cases, people are not accepting this situation. And mental health problem is getting increased day by day. People actually are not accepting the situation. So what they are doing? They are thinking in a negative way. So they are changing the situation, which is not possible. They are criticizing, they are comparing, they are complaining. So you cannot do it, because if you do it, you cannot get rid of the problems. So accept the situation and take the precautions and try to enhance your quality of life by the strategies I have already shared. So get the fact that I have already told, and after carefully knowing all the facts, come to a decision what I should do right now and what I should not do in this COVID-19 situation. I will do only this. And I will not do this. I will think only in this way, and I will not think in this way. So once a decision is carefully reached, definitely it acts. So based on that, I have made my next slide, and it is self-improvement activities. Yes, self-improvement activities is the only way where you can help yourself to overcome from this pandemic situation and to overcome from this situation and to have a better life. First one is use your energy on important things. But unfortunately, we use all our energy on negative thoughts. I don't know why, but from today onwards, we will cut down all the negative thoughts and we will work only on those important activities that those are seriously very important, significant, recognized, and those gives me pleasure. They give me pleasure or satisfaction or relaxation. So focus on one task at a time. People are sometimes things are getting unmanageable while because we all are multitasker and we are doing multiple tasks at a time. No, don't do this. Focus on one task. Give your full concentration, attention on it. Complete the task and move to next task. Control your thinking. Definitely, this is the main important point that you have to work on. You will only get rid of those problems if you have only proper thinking, because our thinking is responsible for having this kind of problems and symptoms. So you have to have a control on your thinking. If you have proper thinking, you have proper way to solve the problems. If you have improper thinking, things will definitely getting unmanageable. Complete each task in a perfect manner as I have just shared. Challenge yourself. How do you do it? You are making one routine day by day. Today, I will complete all these tasks. Today, I will not complete this task. Today, I will have to finish this task. And including this task, including professional tasks, personal activities, schedule me time, activities that gives you pleasure and activities that are really important. So challenge yourself. Definitely, I have full trust in you all that definitely will overcome from it. The last but most important, last but not the least, the most important point I have made for you all is socialize definitely, but only with positive people. Don't socialize with people who do not have any awareness of COVID-19. I have seen in many cases that people are saying COVID-19 will not much have effect on us. Don't take precautions. Don't do anything. Nothing will happen. No, please socialize with positive people who say, yes, I have to take precaution. You have to take precaution. We have to take care of our close ones as well as for ourselves. Why? Because thinking about loved one, closed one, and take care of your family members, friends can be a stress reliever. But it should be balanced with care for yourself, helping others to cope with their stress, such as by providing social support, so it can make your community stronger. So during this time, yes, social distancing is important, but mental distancing is not important. We can get connected through Digital India and we can socialize with people who are delivering positive thoughts. So these are the slides that I have already discussed. In these slides you have got how do you overcome from the situation, what are the mental health problems, how do you channelize yourself towards the right direction, what are the implementation strategies. What are the implementation strategies you can take or adopt to overcome from the situation? And moreover, what are the or how COVID-19 is related to our mental health? So we have already got the experience. We have known it that how COVID-19 is related with our mental health. Now, the most important slide I have made for you all are some thoughts. this, no solution, no overcome would be possible. No matter how many precautions you are taking, no matter how many implementation, how many coping strategies you are adopting or you are going to take, if you do not have proper thoughts, nothing is possible. So my next slides are on some thoughts. Keep it in your mind that your thoughts can change everything. So let's have a look on our first slide based on the thought. So we have to remember always that the more we have positive thoughts, the more we have positivity within ourselves, the more we will be able to channelize ourselves towards the right direction, and definitely we will overcome from this pandemic situation. So the first thought in my box is, your perception and thought can change everything. Please, I would like to request all the participants here, please look at the photos I have shared. You are doing like this. You have this situation. So yes, I'm talking about you. Your perception and thought can change everything. How? Behind the onset of any mental health problems or mental illness, two words are mainly responsible. One is perception, the way I perceive the situation, and the another one is my thought. After perception, what I'm forming within myself. So we all are unique. So our thoughts and perception differ from person to person. It varies from person to person. Life is all about perception. Positive or negative, whichever you choose, it will affect and more than likely reflect your outcomes. So if your perception may not be the reality, the way you perceive the situation may not be the reality. Change your perception, you will change your reality. And if you realize how powerful your thoughts are, you would never think a negative thought. So definitely perception and thought can change everything. How? It can either lead to positivity and change everything, or it can either lead to negativity and change everything, or it leads to positivity and change everything. So my next slide is, stop worrying and start living. How? Like this slide. Look at this slide. If a problem can be solved, no need to worry about it. I have a problem and I have a solution too. So if I have solution, no need to get worried about it. And if I have a problem but I don't have the solution, that means this problem cannot be solved. So if a problem cannot be solved, seriously, what is the use of worrying? Just think about it. Ask yourself. I'm sure definitely will get the answer. So my next slide is, positivity can bring everything. Positivity can change everything. Bring positivity in your outlook, because positivity is only the thing that can change your life. How? Positive thinking, change, generate positive feeling and attract positive life experiences. So positive thinking only give you energy, happiness and help you to get to take all the initiatives. So a negative mind will never give you a positive life. Replace all your negative thoughts with a positive one. I am 100% sure you will definitely overcome from this situation. Definitely overcome from this situation. So based on that, my next slide is, don't complain and criticize what you cannot change. I know that we all are going through a tough situation. We seriously don't know when should we stop, where should we stop, how to deal, how to face, how to adjust, how to cope up, how to modify to fit in this environment. So what we can do? We know that we cannot change the situation, but we can make ourselves give an awareness. We can take the precautions. We can implement all those coping strategies that I have already shared, that have been shared in this platform. Instead of complaining, criticizing, because seriously, we cannot change the situation. We can only change whatever we have within our capacities or whatever we have within our limitations. So please don't complain and criticize. Do what makes you feel happy. So based on that, my next slide is, keyword. What is the keyword? First, we have got experience how COVID-19 is related with mental health. We have got the mental health problems. Sometimes we have experienced these mental health problems little bit, and we have known right now, we have known from this platform that what are the intervention strategies. Now, the important things that we have already shared, what are the thoughts or how do we channelize our thoughts? Here, some key points are there, some key words are there, which will bring, which will complete you, which will make yourself complete. And this is the stage from which you will definitely overcome. Balance and hope. Every day we struggle for existence. Every day we are doing balance. We are making balance between our professional life as well as our personal life. Everywhere we are doing balance. So only balance is the key. Balance in our professional life, in our personal life. Balance in our perception and thinking, balance in our tasks, and balance in necessity and luxury can seriously have a better world and can lead you to the better direction, can channelize yourselves towards the right direction. And what about the hope? Always hope for the best. Why? Because no matter whatever the situation is, it will change, because nothing is permanent in the world, not even our worries. So there is a hope. Please hope for the best. And there is a hope even when your brain tells you there is not. So hope for the best. based on that, my next slide is.
Ma'am, hello.
Sorry?
Yeah, ma'am, sorry to interrupt. Though we are enjoying your session very much, but I'm sorry we are running out of time. So.
Okay, I am presenting my last slide.
Okay.
May I? Okay,
yeah, sure,
okay. Thank you. Okay. So the last slide of this presentation is make yourself believe yourself and make yourself that yes, there is no word called I am impossible, because this word itself says I am possible. So definitely whatever we have discussed in this excellent platform will definitely help us to overcome from the situation, because if seriously we want to get rid of this problem, definitely we can, because if there is will, there is always a way. So last but not the least, thank you all of you. I would like to thank all the wonderful people who have managed time out of their busy personal and professional schedule and join this presentation means a lot to me. And last but not the least, my presentation will be incomplete without mentioning the names of few people: Dr. Shukla Hazra, Principal East Calcutta Girls College, conveners Srimati Orpita Das and Dr. Shimon Kipal. Seriously, I am thankful to you all for giving me this opportunity to conduct such a interaction session and presentation in this prestigious and excellent platform. So looking forward to have more in future. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you, ma'am, for your wonderful presentation. So we will just look at the chat box if anyone has any question. So it's a request to the participants, if you have any question you can drop in the chat box.
Definitely everything will okay very soon. Please try, don't lose the hope. Definitely we will overcome from this.
Panchaliti, are you there?
Hello, am I audible?
Yeah, Panchaliti.
Yeah. Yes, hello. Thank you, madam, so much.
Yeah, you are audible and visible. Yeah, please continue.
Okay. Thank you, madam, for your nice lecture.
Thank you.
Throughout this pandemic period, we have to fight against